Question number 33. This one's got a lot of steps in it, so do your best to keep up. Polar Company has designed an ice block in the shape of a cube. So the volume of the cube is 15,625 centimeters cubed. And the question is asking us, which of the following dimensions is the smallest opening of an ice dispenser that will accommodate length A, B, this diagonal, across the cube? You see it's going from corner to corner there. So in order to solve this, we're going to need to find the length of AB and then find which of these dimensions, A, B, C, or D, is just larger than that length. All we know for right now is the volume of the cube, and that is 15,625 centimeters cubed. That's our volume. Well, we know this thing's a cube, so the volume of a cube is the length of the side cubed, hence the name cube. 15,625 is the length of our side cubed. Why don't we go ahead and find the length of the side by taking the cube root of 15,625. And if you grab your calculator and do that, you should get that S is 25 centimeters. Alright, so now in order to find the length of that diagonal, we're going to have to use Pythagoras here. And if we make a right angle triangle that has that on it, you can see we've got one starting here with the height of the cube and this dimension along the bottom. There we've got a right angle. We don't know what this dimension down here is, x, and we don't know what this dimension is, y. We only know the height is 25. So what can we do? Well, we can find that dimension x that's along the bottom face if we make another right angle triangle along the base of the cube there. Then we know two sides, 25 and 25. So the first step we're going to have to do here is to find x, and then we'll be able to use that to find y. So to do that triangle along the base, we set up 25 squared plus 25 squared is equal to x squared using Pythagoras. 25 squared is 625. And if you add those together, you get 1250. And that's equal to x squared. And I'm not even going to bother taking the square root of this. You'll see why in a sec. You could work it out with the square root of 1250 and whatever that would give you. But why don't we just stop right there, and then let's look at this other triangle that has y in it here. If we use Pythagoras on that, we're going to get 25 squared plus x squared equals y squared. Now you can see why I don't want to work out what x is, because I can just take this value of 1250 and I can put it right in there for x squared, because that's what x squared is. We saw before 25 squared is 625 plus 1250 is equal to y squared. Add those up, we get 1875 is equal to y squared. And so we take the square root of both sides to get y is equal to the square root of 1875. And if you do that on your calculator, that should give you 43.3 something. And then looking at our possible choices here, the answer that is just larger than 43.3 centimeters is 45 centimeters. So answer on this one is C.